We are Soaring Eagles Motor Club. It's a club that rides and drives with a motto. Today we are here to tell you more about traffic rules, why we need to follow them, and what exactly should we do when we are on the road. So we are going to begin with a video. Please do see. Sad but true, and it's happening in India as well. And more shocking, it's happening a lot in Chandigarh also. The reason the club started was because we are very afraid for the coming generation, especially. What are we giving them on our roads? Can they be safe or not? These are some of the facts that we would like to share with you. 1.34 lakh total deaths are there in all over India. 15 to 29 years is the average people who actually die or get involved in accidents. 16 children die on the road every day in India. Two-wheelers account for 25% of total road crashes. 20 children under the age of 14 die every day due to road crashes in the country, and this also involves underage driving. Drunken driving is one of the leading causes of road fatalities, followed by overspeeding. India stands out miserably in the world, by the way, when it comes to road safety records. The reason that we started the club, or rather why Michelangelo started the club, he is the president of the club, he is also an educator in St. John's. He is a painter, he is an artist, he is a musician, he collects bikes. The reason why he started the club was because St. John's is an all-boys school and his students were very keen to buy the latest bikes, the biggest cars. But what worried him was that, will they be safe on the roads? So to teach the children about road safety and what actually to do when you're on the road, the club was started, and then other members, we joined it. So now I would like to invite him to take it further.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, teachers, coordinators, and fellow smart wanderites, right? That's what they call you, right? Okay. Now, SCMC, our goal, if you can read over here, a safe India denotes less fatalities and accidents on our roads. We lose a lot of people on road. A nation built on education, justice, social equality for all, where the dignity of women is upheld, the need of the hour, the environment is enriched for future generations to come, and peace prevails. All these very pertinent points, that's our goal for a very long time. Our immediate missions are again divided into smaller parts: obey traffic rules, save the girl child, save the environment, keep the country clean, and yes, child rights. Children over here, you all have rights, find out what they are. Now, the very most important, safety gear and seat belts. Why we should wear them? Why? It's actually whenever you fall, to reduce the severity of the accident or the fall tendencies. And how can we do that? Now, if you all can you all see the image properly? Is it clear enough? Now, on one side is no protective gear and the other is protective gear. You will see some red markings over here. Can you all see?
Yes.
Right? Can you all see? Teachers over here? Right. Now, these are vulnerable points over here where there is just tissue over bone. There is no muscle. Children over here, if you just touch your shoulders, your elbows, your knees, you can feel the bone and just tissue. Now, these have to be protected. Muscle protects, but not. But in a severe, you know, crash, when you fall from your bike or in your one or two wheeler or cycle, these are the most vulnerable and bones are broken. So wearing this, now moving to the next slide. Full face and open face helmets. Of course, ma'am is showing you a full face and an open face helmet. Both are good, but can anybody tell me which offers maximum protection?
Full face.
Perfect. And yet we don't wear them. Yes. Good. Right? How many of you wear helmets? Billion? Billion, billion? Okay, that's one. Others, you know, don't bother ladies.
Most of the ladies come on scooter and they never wear helmets. That we will talk about.
Ma'am will talk about it. No. We like gender biased. So ma'am wants to talk about the ladies only. So protective gears, gauntlets, and affordable gloves. They're not very expensive, but they're not cheap either. They protect you from injury on your knuckles. It's not only in the winter that you wear gloves. All wear them. You should wear them. It protects you in a fall. Suppose you get hurt in your knuckles or your fingers. How would you text each other? You know, need of the hour. So difficult to text, you know. Fingers, they don't move. Chalte nahi. So please, you know, be safe. You can text your friends. It's easier. Again, most vulnerable parts. The body, elbow guards. When we are skating all, we wear all our gears. Why? Tendency to fall. But why don't we do that when we are pillion or riding a bike or a two-wheeler, a scooter? Why? Answer these questions to yourself. Very, very important to wear proper boots while riding. Of course, you're going in for long rides. Wear proper riding boots. Very, very important. The reason behind them is, if you just wear slippers or, you know, your ankles twist, and that's the most, you know, delicate part of your body in your leg. So they break. And if an ankle breaks, especially when you're walking, you can't walk at all. So it is very, very troublesome. Leather jackets for winters are, it's a tropical country, leather jackets only in winters. You get all weather jackets, you get specialized summer riding jackets. This is a specialized riding jacket. They're not expensive, but it's a one time buy. Because they, now, from inside, if you see, there's a back protector. Now, spinal injuries, they are, you know, there's no, you know, plaster for your, you know, back, your chest, and your skull. So that is why these are mandatory. These jackets have insets, elbow insets, shoulders, protectors, CE approved. So I won't say that you won't get hurt, you won't get bruised, but it does save you from breaking your bone, you know. So a 5,000 rupee jacket may sound a lot of money, but think the kind of money you will spend in the hospital. The kind of time your parents or your relatives, your husband or your in-laws will spend taking care of you. Time is money, like they say. And the trauma every person goes through at home because there's somebody not well or a broken bone is far, far, you know, more expensive than, you know, buying a 5,000 rupee jacket. Save up. That's okay. Gradually you will save up and buy. Wind cheaters, of course, for please, these are not to be worn while riding a scooter, bike, car, whatever, only for the bathroom. Or, you know, maybe going to the beach. I see people wear these to parties, you know. Strange. You must have also. Wrong footwear, wrong places. So these, let them be where they belong. That's why they call them flip-flops. They are not to be, they give you no protection at all. Even in the bathroom, people have fallen wearing this. You know, so they are not safe at all. In the bathroom, they are not safe. Can you imagine on your bike or your scooter, it cannot be safe. So just avoid them totally. They are no good. That's how a person falls from a two-wheeler. Hand first, face first. Now imagine an open face helmet. What's going to happen to your pretty handsome face? Then they will spend so much money on it. Next. Seatbelts. In the video you saw children wearing seatbelts. But how many of you wear seatbelts in the rear seat? Rear seat, back seat. Are you sure? Always seatbelts in your rear seat. Please, I need to clap for them. Thank you so much. Please, that's very nice. If you are wearing seatbelts in the rear seat, you get up and get lost from this. You don't need to attend our seminar. You're doing the right thing. Okay? So, moving next, for those who don't, please pay attention. There's a correct way of wearing it, and that's the incorrect way. And you've seen a lot of people wearing it the incorrect way. I have seen a lot of people below their arms. What's the point? You're scared of a chalan that costs 1,000 rupees. What if your skull is cracked hitting the steering wheel? And I'll tell you why, what happens in the next slide. This is what happens if you incorrectly wear it. You break your spinal cord. And I've seen, you must have seen, people remove the headrest. You want the headrest is for? A whiplash. This. The headrest saves you from a whiplash, your neck being broken. You remove that headrest and you break it. Your seatbelt will save you. You come back and you break your neck and you'll stay this way. You'll die. So, if a car does not have that, do not sit in the front seat. It's given for a reason. It's not a fashion statement. Next time you want to buy a car, go to the car dealer and say, please remove the seatbelt, iske paise kaat do please. See if he can do that for you. Why don't you give an option to please? Seatbelt nikal do yaar, mere ko nahi chahiye. Hum to use hi nahi karte. Hum dhage se kaam chala lenge. Iske paise kaam kar, kam kar, ye to zarurat hi nahi hai mere ko. Okay, so they have put them for a reason. Use them. That's what happens. These are dummies, okay? Those who don't wear are also dummies. So this is what happens. This is exactly, and this is a crash test at the speed of 60 kilometers an hour. This is not a 120 kilometers an hour crash test. This is a 60 kilometers an hour crash test. I was two of my students this way. They were not wearing. One was riding a Pajero on the Zirakpur highway. You must have read about it. He flew through the windscreen and down the highway. That was my student from St. John's. That drove me to, you know, start this club and, you know, start educating as many, you know, students and people. Losing life, a son is gone, daughter is gone, what's left? So please wear your seatbelts. Yes, they really save. You can read on your own. Seatbelts reduce risks of death. It reduces. I will not say, you know, you won't die. If you're supposed to die, you will die. But it reduces it by 45% and 50% serious injury. Now serious injury is breaking your back, breaking your neck. 50%. Pretty good enough. Now, 30 times more likely to be ejected if not wearing a seatbelt. 30 times. Sometimes you're not even, you know, driving fast and somebody hits you from the back. You're not wearing a seatbelt. Your head lands straight onto the steering wheel or the dashboard. Now, you're not driving. The airbags are supposed to be deployed at a speed of 40 kilometers an hour or 60. Hondas are around 60. So you're not driving at all, but somebody hits you from the back. The airbags won't deploy. So these are the things we don't take care of. Now, distractions. Now, please watch. We all do this. We all have done this while driving. Please watch.
What are you afraid of missing today? A 2-second glance doubles the risk of crashing. So what are you really missing?
Obscene gestures, that is road rage. Overspeeding is also a form of road rage. And it has become such a menace that Delhi police is now being armed to control road rage. These are some of the ways that road rage occurs. The reason that has been found is, number one, people have less patience now on the road. Some get out of the house because they fought with somebody. The anger is spilled on the roads. They have not got out of the house on time. They want to rush. So they would rather jump a red light and reach on time. These are actual footage of road rage, and this is what is actually happening every second moment in India as well. It's not just abroad. Abroad it is still controlled. Road rage is rampant in India. The only way we can help ourselves is, number one, if you know you're angry, you're upset, please don't drive or ride. You may not know it, but you will be driving wrong or you will be riding wrong. Number one. Number two, if somebody is honking excessively from behind, don't react. Give way, let the person pass. There is no need to show that, yes, I'm a man, I can fight it out. Not required. You will be a better gentleman if you let that person go. Fine? So we can avoid road rage, and more important is overspeeding. You must have seen that all over Chandigarh there are speed limits given on the roads. Can you tell me why are the speed limits there? Because the road construction is of that kind, number one. Number two, it is to make sure that you drive at a speed where you can brake easily, because the road is specified for certain speed only. Alright? We will be showing you certain footage later about Chandigarh only. What happens when you overspeed? Can we move back, Manu, please? Yes. These signs may not be visible on your speedometer, but they are there to explain something to you. At the speed of 100 or 120, you will either be crippled, or you will be a vegetable, or you will die. That is for sure. These are the three things that happens when you overspeed. Next, please, Manu. These are the paper cuttings for Chandigarh only. And this is now coming every second day. It's not just that it is, you know, once maybe in a month or 2 months. Yes, very dear to my heart, women riders and drivers. I have been seeing even in our school, a lot of ladies come on their two-wheelers, yes? I think a lot of us sit as pillions also. And as Michael sir had asked you earlier, that do you wear helmets? Let's have a very frank show of hands. How many of us actually wear a helmet? That's great. How many of us actually sit on a two-wheeler but we don't wear a helmet? I know a lot who don't. Yes? That goes for the ladies here also, class 9th and 10th. Yes? Why not? Are we so headstrong that nothing can happen to us? I know we are headstrong. We are very, very good at our brains. But we need to protect ourselves. Just because it is not a law, we don't do it. But that is not the right thing to do. I have asked a lot of girls on the red lights, you know, why do you cover your face? Ma'am, I get tanned. Great. What about the head? Ma'am, why don't you wear a helmet? Ma'am, baal kharab ho jayenge. Baal ban jayenge. Even I come here, I go up and I comb my hair. It doesn't matter to me. I need to save my head. Yes? So let's wear the helmet. If you're so interested in saving your skin, save your head as well.
That's your ma'am.
Yes, always wear a helmet. Make your children wear a helmet. Angelo, would you like to please come up? Angelo is Michael and Kelly's son. Whenever he is told that they are going out, he asks the first question, are we going on the bike? They say yes. He goes, he gets his knee pads, his elbow pads, and then he'll show you what he does. Learned the first thing is to wear a helmet. He is not allowed to sit on the bike unless until he is wearing his helmet. And now he himself doesn't know to do it. So that is what we have to teach ourselves also. Alright? Please don't tailgate. Tailgate, can anybody tell me what is tailgating? How do you tailgate? When you drive too close to a vehicle in front. It does not give you braking space. So please stay away from the vehicle in front. And ladies, the rear view mirror is for putting lipstick, but please adjust it back, okay? It is to be used for seeing the traffic at the back, not just for doing your makeup. Once the makeup is over, and make sure you're not doing it while the car is moving. Adjust it back and make sure that you see at the back what is happening. Now, that's a beautiful picture, a mother who actually cares. She's got both the children also wearing a helmet, and she's also wearing a helmet. But on the other hand, we have a dear father. Do I care? I don't care about myself. I care to roots about my family. Yes? He is sitting pretty. The children are also sitting pretty. No helmets required at all. Not very safe at all. And you know, when he sees a policeman, he'll quickly wear a helmet. But he's not bothered about the family. The reason why we insist on pilgrims wearing a helmet is the one who's riding the two-wheeler, if he's going to be involved in an accident, he gets to know. He or she can save herself. The pilgrim never gets to know. The pilgrim can never save herself or himself. I have actually witnessed ladies falling off because the husband or the brother, they have braked suddenly. They didn't know. And they have fallen off. So let's take care of ourselves and their health, right? Those are some of the statistics from Chandigarh. Another thing that sir has just reminded me, how many of us have small children in our houses? Anyone who has small children? So when you're going in the car, where do they sit? In your lap, no? And you hold them with your hands? And do you strap them in the seatbelt? No. You're supposed to. You'll see a lot of ladies, and if you ask them, you tap on the window, ma'am, bachcha aapne godi mein kyun pakda? Nahi ji, maine to seatbelt pehni, mere haath se maine usko pakda hua hai. But you know, in this scenario, if there's an accident, the first thing the lady will do is?
Yes.
She will leave her hands open, and the child will go fly to the windscreen. So never keep your children in your lap. Your arms are not safety belts. Strap them at the back. Make sure that they wear the seatbelt. It is required. We'll share a video now.
All right. Good morning, Aurel. So what did you notice in this video? Anyone? Don't drink and drive, else you'll die. Don't let anybody drink and drive. Even if your parents or if dad or dad drinks, you just say, "Dad, I'm not sitting with you in your car." Period. That's it. Call a taxi. Even if ma'am, your husband's drink, this, you just need to say, "I'm not sitting with you because you're drunk." That's it. Because whenever a person drinks, he dies and he even kills the other person. The next slide, please. These are some of the facts and figures which I'll be sharing with you. The major cause of accidents is drunk driving. 70% of the accidents occur due to drunk driving. 1 lakh people were killed last year due to drunk driving. Every 2 minutes a person is injured, again, due to drunk driving. The rate of drunk driving is highest between the age of 26 and 29 years. And an estimated of 32% of fatal car accidents in which a person has lost his life or there has been a major injury is due to drunk driving. Next slide, please. Alcohol, how it attacks your brain. If the brain is attacked, your body is attacked. The first phase, it attacks its your motor hand and hand-eye coordination, the limbs coordination, they slow down. The second phase, it attacks your emotions. You lose emotions. If you start crying, you start crying. In the video, you must have noticed a lady, the feeling of anxiety. You lose your patience. You tend to ride fast. That's the second phase of alcohol attack. And the last and the final phase of alcohol attack is it affects your heart rate, body temperature, appetite and consciousness. And if you lose consciousness while driving or riding, you're gone. You damage yourself, your family and the others whom you have hit. So avoid alcohol, don't sit with people, don't sit with parents who drink alcohol. Just say, "I'll call a taxi," or "You need to call a taxi to reach back home," or "I'll drive." The next slide, please. So, whenever you drink alcohol, you get a tunnel vision. Now, I would request everybody to just do like this. So, you cannot see a person who's coming from left side or your right side. That's how you see when you are drunk. That's what's known as a tunnel vision. So, you see only front. This is the view which you get. You have no idea what the traffic approaching from the left or the right, and that's the major cause of accidents. So next slide, please. A small video, and then we move forward.
All around me are familiar faces.
Before I start off with this topic, I want to ask you one question. Does anybody know how the police humiliates a person who is drunk? If you are found drunk at night, the police picks you up, asks you where your home is, drops you about 4 to 5 houses before your home, plays the siren so that everybody in the neighborhood is informed that that particular person is drunk. He was drinking and driving, and the next day they come to your house and they charge you whatever the penalty is, or if he needs to go to the court or if he needs to go to the jail. But the first thing they do, they humiliate you in your neighborhood. That's what police have started doing now. So moving on to the next topic, traffic signs and signals. Most of us, or rather I should say all of us, know this, but none of us or some of us follow. The traffic signs are divided into three main categories. The first one being the mandatory signs, which you have to follow, there is no choice. Second, caution. Wherever there's a caution sign, you need to slow down your vehicle. Either there's some work going on or there's a school nearby. And the third one is information, which gives you information. The next slide, please. Wherever you see a red circle, this means what should not be done. So I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. What does the second sign indicate? I need an answer. I won't be moving forward. What does the second sign indicate? Come on, you must have seen. The second sign indicates do not enter. You need not enter that road. Either a tree is fallen or either there's some road blockage on that road. What's the third sign?
One way,
correct. Fourth?
No
overtaking. Fifth?
No.
And where's no honking seen?
Hospitals,
yeah, correct. So wherever there's a red circle and a stripe, you should not do that. The next slide, please. The first sign indicates the speed limit. What does the second and the third? It's written width and height limit. Where are these seen? The second and the third. The width limit and the height limit. Mostly used for buses and trucks.
Under bridges and all.
Correct. Under bridges, basements,
barriers,
tunnels, narrow bridges. These all are seen over there. The next slide, please. Blue circle indicates what should be done. What does the second indicate? Compulsory left. The third? Fourth? And where is the scene?
Mountains,
blind turns, basements, when you take a blind turn. The last one, what does the fifth symbol indicate?
Slope downwards?
No, it indicates keep your vehicle towards your left. You need to slow down and keep your vehicle towards your left. The next slide, please. Triangle, wherever you see a triangle, caution. Triangle means slow down your vehicle. Anything between a triangle, slow down your vehicle. The second sign?
School.
Slow down your vehicle. Third?
No.
Crossroads. Slow down your vehicle. Crossroad. The fourth sign, it's written give way. Where is it?
Slip.
Place, this symbol.
Slip road.
Slip road, correct sir. Whenever you are in a slip road, you need to slow down your vehicle and give way to the traffic on the main road. Triangle, slow down your vehicle, give way and then move on. The fifth. Correct. Slow down your vehicle. Narrow road ahead. Sixth.
Construction.
Slow down your vehicle. Seventh. Narrow bridge. Slow down your vehicle. So wherever there's a triangle, slow down your vehicle. Blue triangle. Information. The second, it just gives normal information. Delhi, Noida. The third gives not. What's the difference between the... I'll come to the sixth and seventh later. The toll booth ahead. What's a truck lay by? Fifth.
Only for
on the main highway, there's a segregated area and trucks have to go
from that side. Trucks don't have to go from that side. If a truck driver needs to stop on the road, it cannot park on the main road on the national highway. So there are truck laybys over there, where they can take their trucks, park their trucks over there and rest for a few minutes if they want. What's the difference between the 6th and the 7th? You can stand up and see if you want. 6th and the 7th. And yeah, stand up and just...
Yeah.
6th and 7th. No. 6th and 7th. Anybody else? Sit down. 6th and 7th. Raise hands, please. Yes?
Maybe 7th one is a dispensary.
Okay, good. Yes, sir?
6th number is hospital.
Yes.
And 7th number is hospital.
Correct, sir. The next slide. Hospital and the first aid post. Wherever there's a hospital, you'll get all the facilities which are available in a hospital. But wherever there's a first aid post, you'll only get a first aid kit. You'll get a bandage, you'll get a Dettol. A first aid kit will be available, but no facilities. Next slide, please. Edge lines and yellow edge lines. You must have noticed, while moving on a road, there's a white line, and some places there's a yellow line on your left. What does the white line indicate? The white line on your left side indicates you can stop your vehicle on that road if there's an emergency, if there's no traffic. You can slow down, take your vehicle towards your left and slow down. And what does the yellow line indicate? Even if there's an emergency, you cannot stop on a road where there's a yellow line. For example, in front of Raj Bhavan. And you must have noticed a yellow line between 16 and 17. It's more towards the center, like about 3/4. What does that yellow line indicate? You must have noticed chalans happening on that road. Correct. Only taxis, buses and ambulance can move towards the left of the yellow line. And if you take your car or your scooter or any vehicle towards left of the yellow line, the police will be there and you will ask why this chalan for. And it has happened many times. The next slide, please. So red means stop, green means go. Yellow?
Wait.
And if the light is turning from green to yellow?
Slow down.
If you are on a zebra crossing, you can cross the light. And if you are not on a zebra crossing, you have to stop on the yellow light, which is going to turn red. Do not speed up your vehicle. The next slide, please. Flashing lights. You must have seen yellow flashing lights or red flashing lights.
Warning.
Slow down your vehicle. Pedestrians ahead or some construction going on or some breakdown ahead on the road. So you need to slow down and drive with caution. Pedestrian signals. Red, stop. Green, the pedestrian can go. Anybody who knows what's jaywalking? Crossing the road, not from a zebra crossing, is known as jaywalking. And if you cross the road from a zebra crossing, that's the correct way. If any one of you have traveled outside India, there's a challan for jaywalking. They penalize you that you are jaywalking and try not to jaywalk. Try always to cross a road through a zebra crossing. The next slide, please. What's this?
Zebra.
And what's it for? if you are in a vehicle. Pedestrians to cross the road. And if you are riding a vehicle, what does this mean for you?
Stop before the line.
Correct. Stop before the line. And how many of you stop on the line or ahead of the line? And why do you do that?
Over anxiousness to have the desire to repeat that they will win a race or problem.
That's not correct. That's not correct. You should always stop before, because if a person is crossing a line, crossing a pedestrian is crossing the road, he needs a zebra crossing. If you have your right to ride on road, they have the right to cross the roads through zebra crossing. Please don't stop on the zebra crossing. Now, police has started challaning the vehicles. They've just started it. Standing on a zebra crossing, after a zebra crossing. Always try to stop your vehicle before a zebra crossing. Next. The zebra crossing. Next. Here are some CCTV footages I would like to share from Chandigarh itself. These are taken from the Chandigarh traffic police. So I would just like to share these footages. 1617 light point. Sir, pause the video, 1 minute. See this? You see this yellow line, which, the one I was talking about? Only taxis, buses and ambulance can move here. You cannot, this is between the 16 and the 17 I was talking about. And now you can play the video.
Prevention of cure pedestrians. We all at some times do crossroads.
always walk on the footpath rather than on the road. Is it clear? Even if there's no footpath there, please always avoid the road, because you don't know what's coming from behind or who is driving rashly. Always, you know, try to wear light colored clothes and reflective clothing, so that, you know, nowadays a lot of Adidas, Nikes and all, they all come with a small dot over here, you know, so that's the reflective thing for your night when you're out. Like Manu said, always use a zebra crossing, don't jaywalk. Running should be done in parks rather than on the roads. Never run on the roads, it's also not good for your knees and joints. Is it clear? Always run on soft grass. Cycle safety, we all ride cycles. How many of you still riding cycles? This side. Okay, the others don't. Okay, good. Health conscious everybody over here. Most of you are still riding cycles. There are certain rules to wearing riding a cycle. Always wear a helmet, same two-wheeler rules which I spoke earlier. Wherever there is a cycle track, use it. Okay? And stay on the left side of the road, the extreme left. As maximum as possible. You want to turn right, stop your cycle for your safety. Look left, look right. It was told when you were a kid. I am telling you, lift left, right, and then left again. Okay, because while you were looking at the right side of the road, thinking somebody would come from your left, because the traffic is moving this side. So then cross, get down from your cycle and cross the road. Don't try to cycle because you're stationary, and then always check that you have front reflectors, rear reflectors, brakes and tire pressure is very important. The reason is because if you're riding low pressure on your tires, tend to get punctured, of course, but then your speed is, you know, you need to put a lot of effort while cycling, and then when you want to move out from a sticky situation, your cycle will let you down. Remember, children below the age of 13, why is this rule? Below the age of 13 should not be cycling on the main roads. Anybody can tell me? Anybody? Children below the age of 13 do not have rational thinking. They cannot calculate distance. They cannot calculate time, distance, and you know how speed. So that is why it's only about 13 that you should allow your child to venture out on the main road. Knee and elbow guards, of course. Height of the seat, boy especially, you know, try to keep it below your waist. You don't need to show off, because broken bones will only get you sympathy and nothing else. Again, I said look left, right, and left again. Next slide. Yeah, have some mercy on the road. These are some things come out of the government. You will not, if you help somebody, you're being a good Samaritan, please go ahead. There's nothing that the government is going to hold against you if you help somebody, some accident victim. It could be somebody you know, that you have saved, or somebody just because, you know, it's a good deed, you should be doing that. There's a few things. First, check whether there is any danger to yourself if you are part of the accident, okay? If you are involved in an accident, so remember this. First, see that you are okay, and then look after the victim. Get out of the crashed vehicle as soon as possible. Very, very important. Because it could ignite. You know, in movies they show as soon as it crashes, bursts into flame. It does not happen. It takes time. So send someone to warn approaching traffic, because you may, while you're getting out of the vehicle, somebody may run over you. So be very careful. Ask for help. And tell somebody to stop the approaching vehicle, because you are not in your senses to do that. And the first thing is call 108. This is a national, you know, helpline. Never run away from the scene. If you're in, you know, part of an accident, no, because the law will catch you. Always call the police. Don't just not call. Neglect posting accident formalities. Make that. Don't get aggressive. Don't fight. No good. Instead, just try to calm that situation down and avoid it. And of course, documentation is very important, because sometimes if you have wrong documentation, even if it's not your fault, you'll be convicted. So don't do that. Smartphones, but not so smart people for video. Yeah, CCTV footage. Yeah. basically is drive to live, not to die. That's what we believe in. And thank you so much for, you know, being so patient, and thanks for this. Thank you. We know that you know, it's affecting you, that's why you are into it. We like to call upon Ira ma'am, Manu, Subbu for... Ira ma'am is our the SCMC secretary. Manu is the sergeant at arms. We don't deal in arms and ammunitions, but he manages all our rights and, you know, looks after the nitty-gritties of all the rights details. Gulshan is not here, he is the treasurer and secretary, vice president. His mom is seriously ill. We have another member amongst us, is Mohit sir over there at the back. He is also a member of SCMC. Tomorrow he will be supporting us also. We are having a campaign for lane driving to educate people at the lake. Anybody is interested, give your names of your vehicles and vehicle number and name to Ira ma'am, so that, you know, we can do the formalities. It's in the evening at 3:45. It's a no vehicle zone, so you will have to come and collect with your vehicle a special sticker that we'll issue you. Then you can enter the Sukhna Lake premises with your vehicle. It will take an hour. It's an hour's program. By 5:30, you will be free. So it's to educate people for lane driving, to stay in your lane. So we have a group of cyclists, bikers, and four-wheelers. So they will all be riding, you know, 1 kilometer around the lake, educating people for lane driving. It's very important. Thank you so much, and hope you, I won't say enjoyed it, but hope you were sensitized and learned something. And I hope you will go and buy helmets for your head. And thank you.
Thank you, Michael sir, Ira ma'am, Manu, and little Angelo for coming here and educating all of us. Some of the videos were disturbing, but the purpose was to arouse sensitivity, because we always keep thinking that it can't happen to us. We always keep thinking that it happens to others because we see it in the news, read it in the newspaper. But these videos and these images are good enough, they were sensitive enough to make us aware and keep us alert all the time when we are on the road. And like I always tell you, children especially, that even if you see your parents, elders making mistake, what you are supposed to do?
Say nothing.
Politely check them. But you keep forgetting. Not making mistake is important, but checking someone who's making mistake is all the more important. And if a child checks an adult, then the effect is more. They feel ashamed, even if they might scold you a couple of times, but if you are at it all the time, persistent, then they will listen to you. And we expect changes from you only, because when we are adults, it is very difficult to change habits. But you can change your elders' habits, and you can form good habits for yourselves. So will you remember this, all that you saw, and educate more and more people? Does this team expect that you will spread the message to more and more people in your neighborhood, acquaintances, families? We will see, and all the best. Keep at it. And thank you once again, Team SMC, for coming here and giving your precious time and education.